Faith comes by hearing, and hearing the word of God. You're listening to The Moment of Power with Azano Eddie Thompson. Daily audio devotions to energize your day, presented by the Advent Hero Ministries.
Our Moment of Power topic today is The Power of Knowledge, Part 2. And this is life eternal, that they might know thee, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom thou hast sent. John 17:3. Eternal life is not just about faith or belief. You must believe in something you know for sure that is right and true. If you believe in a God or Christ, or gospel, or spirit, by the way, all are connected, that is not true, you will have to stand the chance of losing eternal life. Paul warned the Corinthians and Galatians against receiving or believing in a false gospel, a false Christ, and false spirit. Quote, "But I fear lest by any means, as the serpent beguiled Eve through the subtlety, so your minds should be corrupted from the simplicity that is in Christ. For if he that cometh preacheth another Jesus, whom we have not preached, or if ye receive another spirit, which ye have not received, or another gospel which ye have not accepted, ye might well bear with him," unquote. 2 Corinthians 11:3-4. Quote, "I marvel that ye are so soon removed from him that called you into the grace of Christ unto another gospel, which is not another, but there be some that trouble you and would pervert the gospel of Christ," unquote. Galatians 1:6-7. So you do not only need the knowledge of God, you need the knowledge of the true God. You need the knowledge of the true Christ. You need the knowledge of the true gospel, and you need the knowledge of the true spirit. If you don't care to know, your salvation is not guaranteed. That is why Paul wrote to Timothy that God, quote, "will have all men to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. For there is one God and one mediator between God and man, the man Christ Jesus, who gave himself a ransom for all to be testified in due time," unquote. 1 Timothy 2:4-6. Satan has been trying to foist his counterfeit gods, Jesus's, gospels, spirits on the church from the first century, and he's still in the game. Only those who will prayerfully study their Bibles can know the true God and Jesus Christ, whom he has sent, and be saved. It is very important that we begin to study our Bibles, because these things can be so subtle and sometimes not so subtle. But we must give our hearts to God. And we must open our hearts to the true Spirit of God to reveal the things of God to us. When we do this, we will be experiencing the grace and the power of God unto salvation. For God will have all men to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. This is the moment of power. May your mind and heart be open to the truth today. In Jesus' name, amen.